I hope everybody is good. Today we want to talk, or maybe let me say, expose the true location. South Africa is the root of the tree of life, is the Garden of Eden, is true Israel, is the holy mountains of Sonini Nanini, the maker of heaven and earth, and then is also Canaan, aka promised land. Why I'm doing this, I'm stressing this a lot because there's some people who still believe, looking at the Middle East, what is happening, comparing the end time prophecies, they don't see things that is going on in South Africa because they're looking in the wrong place. The South African are the chosen nation, the children of Izakele, the royal priesthood of Sonini from beyond the rivers of Kush, Zephaniah 3 and 10. These are the people who are called by the Messiah's name. I'm not saying only that the South Africans are the only Israel, but South Africans are the remnant. Okay? Why are they the remnant? Are the people who rejected Abu Salam Aleikum? That is why then you will understand that the Messiah and the God of the Salam Aleikums are two different story. I believe that you understand when I say Salam Aleikum, because when I mention the name, they mostly will take my videos down, and I don't want that to happen, okay? The foreigners reside in MZANSI, in South Africa, for example, causing havoc, oppressing them, and doing all this wickedness to the South Africans. There's judgment for them, right? And the Messiah said he will not allow the wicked to rule over his people because they came to take over. But the Messiah is promising us here in Psalm 125 verse 3 that he will not allow that to happen because he doesn't want to have to deal with the God of the Salam Aleikum before his time come. And to the, for example, the Zai, they know themselves the Zimbos, who actually already took over that everywhere in South Africa. Government, the Home Affairs, they are there, even to the human rights. These are the people who are selling our passports to their people, all right? So because the thing with the Zamzam, the Zippers, is because we're having the same name, like Gabo Dlamini, Abo Ndlovu, all these things. So that's the reason why we can't even see them, you know. They are wolf in sheep clothing. These are the people doing all this, what they're doing. And, you know, we know them. They are already in our TV, you know. So, okay, then will be a snake will sell his people. That is why they're doing what they're doing. But I want to give it to you. Look at this scripture here. It says that there is a way that seems right to a man, but at the end is what? Death. Proverbs 16:25. And the Messiah said, he shall feed those who are oppressing us, because they are oppressing us and humiliating us for doing what they're doing. Okay, the Messiah will allow them to drink, to eat of their own flesh and drink of their own blood instead of a sweet one. And all these nations, we're talking about the children of Salam Aleikum, they are already in South Africa, like I've said in Ezekiel 38, from 1, you can take from 1 till 12, you will see that these are the people who are coming to attack the people of the Messiah. They will fight against you. Why? Because they hate the Messiah. Christ said they will hate you because they hated me first, and they hate the remnant of the Messiah. They're coming into forcing us into their religion of the Salam Aleikum, which is the religion of Lomubilo. So this is what they came to take over, but the Messiah said he won't allow them to do that, and then he will deal with them so they will know that he is our Redeemer, our Savior, the Mighty One of Jacob. These are the nations I'm talking about that will attack the Bantu people in the last days. They're already in South Africa, as you see them, the Pakistan, the Ethiopians, the Libyans, and all the United Arab Europeans, which are those in the Middle East. Actually, they were called the Vandals and the Ostrogoths. You call them Jews today. All these people are coming against you, all right? All these people, mostly these people I'm talking about, they are from the religion of the Salam Aleikum, you know, the one another, come, let us destroy them so that the name Israel won't be in remembrance again. That is why they will do what they will do with the sword of I do it, because the Messiah will allow them to do, because why? You, Mzansi, you fail to repent. You join in them in doing wickedness. That is why the Messiah will punish you so that you will return to him. Things will happen in South Africa that is not so jolly, okay? It's real to receive Christ as your personal Lord and Savior and keep the commandments and keep the Sabbath of the Messiah. Watch and pray. All right. So, Bantaze, we came to the end of our message today. May the Messiah be with you, protect and guide and provide for your needs. Bye-bye. Nisalenia.